What's good, y'all? Welcome back to my channel, Crispy Talks. Y'all call me Crispy. And tomorrow's Thanksgiving. Happy food day, y'all. Because tomorrow's Thanksgiving, I have to think about a Thanksgiving-related video to do. What other sense does it make than to eat with my family? And y'all are my family. So we finna eat, bitch, and we finna crack jokes. It's kind of funny because I'm recording here at school in Washington, D.C. right now, looking crusty. But I know when I be posting this, I'm gonna be in my bed just like y'all. With my hair retwisted, watch out for that video coming up next. Right now, we both waited to eat some food, mom. So today I'm going to be making a Thanksgiving mukbang. Happy food day. And to start it off, I'm going to be answering 2 to 3 questions Thanksgiving related that I asked you guys and made up, or questions that I made up by myself. And for the other half of this video, I'm going to be reacting to Thanksgiving clapbacks in this bitch. So I am eating my favorite, the Cheesecake Factory. If you ever want a chance to win my heart, all you gotta do is buy me some boneless buffalo wings, and I promise you I will be sucking your dick. If y'all ever ate from Cheesecake Factory, brown bread, bitch, like, I would sell my soul for some brown bread. Look what they gave me. Bitch, they usually give me 2 loads of brown bread. And what the fuck is this? What's going on? We got some french fries. We got our brown bread. Y'all know I gotta show y'all what I'm working with. Just some boneless buffalo tenders. I don't eat the celery. We just gonna put this to the side, but we drinking some water on the side because we healthy bitches. If somebody ever told me to kill my family to get some brown bread, bitch. So one of my followers, Brooklyn B, yeah, shout out to Brooklyn, you already know, bitch. But they asked me, what's your favorite thing about Thanksgiving? Y'all already know, but y'all already know. I swear to this day, food will always make me moan better than sex will. Oh, besides the obvious, what I like about Thanksgiving now, so since I've been away from home, like in school, I can say that now, emphasis on the now, that I can appreciate my family's presence just a little bit more, you know, now. So honestly, I can say that being with my family at this point is my second favorite thing about Thanksgiving. Because honestly, I know there's people who be like, oh, I'm antisocial, I don't like talking to nobody in school and stuff like that. But half the time, they be the ones who be having the most friends and everything, but they swear that they don't. No, but no, I'm actually one of those antisocial people. Like, I don't be talking to nobody, honestly. I'm on that summer walker status, like, not even on no funny shit. I couldn't even eat at the cafeteria for the longest because of my anxiety. And for the most part, I just don't like people. I don't be trying to talk to nobody. So I don't really have that embracing feeling that I get around my family. I be by myself most of the time. Or I have 1 or 2 people that I hang out with, which there's nothing wrong with that. I always say that I don't need the whole world to be my friend. Like, if anything, at least 1 person could be my friend, I'll be good. But sometimes it'd be lonely up in this bitch. So like, so now that I go home, it's not the same. It's just nice to be in a house full of people that you know loves you and cares about you. And like, and to be in a room with people who it's not even like, oh, the person next to you, I'll take a bullet for. It's the person on each side of you. Everybody in that room would take a bullet for. It's nice to be in a room where at the same time, as much as I wanna hug you and tell you I love you, I would still push you away and tell you not to touch me. You know, I really fuck with having that type of relationship. And with my family, we not affectionate, honestly. You can tell that we love each other more on the passion behind our arguments than any type of affection that we be trying to throw at each other. So yeah, I'm just enjoying being around my family at this point. Also, please comment down y'all answers to these questions too, because I love talking to y'all, like I always say. So yeah, my favorite thing about Thanksgiving, besides the obvious, is being around my family, being around people that I love. Ooh. Oh, thank you, Jesus. So a question that I had wrote to myself and to you guys was, what food did we usually eat? And boy, let me tell you about manger haïtien, man. Ouf, I connais. For those of you who don't know, I'm haïtien American, okay? I am Haitian American. and I was raised in a Haitian household, so we be getting that Haitian food. I mean, I don't be liking all the Haitian food, you know, don't get me wrong, but that's just to give you an idea of the kind of food that we have at Thanksgiving. So let me tell y'all about this bullshit, okay? I'm here to tell y'all that my family, okay, my Haitian ass family, we have not eaten a traditional turkey. Like, we never had a turkey that looked like this, okay? We had turkeys that looked like this, if I could find a picture. My family hates me so bad. I'm just kidding, but they hate me so bad that they just couldn't be normal. Like, so my mom or my dad, they will cut up the turkey and they pretty much fry it in a pan. They cook it on the stove. Yeah. And they cut that bitch up. So, I'm not gonna lie, man. My mom's seasoning is so fucking good. Like, honestly, I'm not upset with fried turkey at all. Like, as much as I wish that we had a regular Thanksgiving, my mom's fried turkey is so good. And she makes that with usually brown rice, I wanna say. Brown rice. And of course you have to have the macaroni and cheese, but y'all could revoke my card all y'all want, but I don't eat macaroni and cheese. I'm a picky ass eater and I don't like cheese like that. I used to be a child and take these cheese slices out the refrigerator and eat that. And I think maybe that's what fucked me up. But now, honestly, in terms of cheese, I only eat mozzarella sticks, like mozzarella. So I don't like macaroni and cheese. My mom makes that. She'll make that with lasagna, with beef. I don't eat lasagna either. My mom also makes pink salad, and this is like a traditional Haitian food. This is something you'll always see at the parties and the cookouts if you're invited. I don't really remember what else my mom makes, but usually I'll be over here eating turkey, brown rice, and pickles. Woo! If y'all never had pickles in your life by now, then what is y'all doing? And yeah, I'm not the type of person y'all wanna go out to eat with, but like, we could always miss up the work as long as y'all got some chicken. Like, I'm that friend. And the last question I wrote that I'll be answering, that I want y'all to answer too in the comments down below, is for Thanksgiving, when you out with your boo and all, would you be afraid to meet their parents for the first time or their kids for the first time for Thanksgiving? I'm trying to think about moms versus kids. Like, okay, let's talk about specifics here. We got, you know, we got basic middle-aged parents, but we got like, let's say 5-year-old kids, like 5-6-year-old kids, because they the badass kids. That's the age where the kids will tell you you're ugly and your breath stink and you need to brush your teeth. Like, so we got some judgmental ass kids and a middle-aged mom who is protective over her son, or dad protected over his daughter. So what would you rather deal with, the parents or the kids? I would rather deal with the parents, because kids have hurt my feelings. Like, kids have hurt my feelings more than adults. I have a 5-year-old nephew at home. I think he's 5. And he's very, he got a big ass mouth and he's not afraid to be honest, like brutally honest. And if he wasn't my nephew, and I couldn't beat his ass. But at the same time, he's my nephew, so I could beat his ass. But if I had to deal with somebody else's kids and I couldn't even beat their ass, bitch, like, I don't even have, it's not even that I would beat their ass, but I don't even have the option to beat their ass. Like, and they just talking reckless, and I mean, I don't know. Like, kids, you might be able to win their heart over with some candy, but like, or some crack, but like, parents, bitch, like, they are judging your every breath and move and anything possible, because I know damn well I want the best for whatever I pull out of my vagina for 9 months. Like, no, bitch. Like, my child is not going through the heartbreak and the bullshit that I'm going through as long as I can help it. I wanna say I would rather deal with the parents, because, you know, they're easier to like win over and talk to and have like a grown-up conversation, and just me be like, I want to fuck your son for the rest of my life. So eventually they're just gonna have to get over it. With the kids, if you're messing with the parent of the child, if their child don't like you, it could be a deal breaker. But if their parents don't like you and they love you and they're not like a mama slash daddy's child, then they might be able to look past that and still fuck with you. Cause honestly, I can say for me, my parents or my child ain't gonna have no say in who I decide to fuck, but or marry. But if my child, or in a lot of other people's cases, if their child don't mess with you, I ain't wanna talk no more, bitch. I'm hungry, but I do wanna laugh. So let's look at some Thanksgiving clapbacks, bitch. And I'm gonna put that on the screen right next to me. Honestly, I appreciate y'all who are watching this, cause I don't know who would want to watch somebody eat, but like I said, we eating together, bitch. The aunt, stay out of girl folk talk. I mean, stay out of married men houses. I know a couple aunties in my generation who's gonna have these clapbacks in the future. Honestly, I'll be damned if my niece has the audacity to throw this back in my face for Thanksgiving clapback. Bitch, if I'm over here telling you niece or nephew that I'm messing with a married man, and you have the nerve to put that in my face for Thanksgiving, bitch, like, that's wrong. Like, you officially cut off the family. This your fifth year in school you ever graduated. This your fifth year, this your seventh year with Mr. Ray, he ever leaving his wife. Please, Mr. Ray ain't leaving his wife. 7 years, bitch, I am not spending 7 years with somebody who's married, like, mm-mm. And I bet you, if they told us who the family member was, it would've been the auntie. Like, everybody coming for the auntie. Like, why everybody coming for the auntie though? Like, y'all really dead ass hating on us. This says, here we go with the aunt again. Aunt, remember when you played with them little dolls? Remember when your husband played with them little girls? This is not a clapback because the aunt never said nothing crazy. The aunt only said, remember when you played with them little girls, with the little dolls, like. And then this little niece nephew just came at the husband playing with girls. Mm-mm. So at this point, if you are aunt, basically you messing with married men and your husband is messing with little girls. Like, this is a fucked up family. Grandma, you always on that damn phone. Me, you always on that damn walker. Hold on now, we ain't coming for grandma, cause grandma making sure we eat. And she gotta walk with that walker there. Grandma, pull up your pants, me, pull up your titties. I ain't looking at my grandma's titties to be telling her to pull them up. Grandma can't pull up these titties, man. And if I was grandma, I'd be like, bitch, you suck these titties. Oh, 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 bitch. I know y'all hear that. Dry ass caca fry. Family member, I wasn't drinking when I was 16. Me, can't drink when you're pregnant. This is so foul. This is the best clapback so far. By the way, let me know what y'all think is the best clapback. But this one, because bitch, you can't come at me for drinking underage and you just fucking raw out here 16. You know your tattoos are a lifetime commitment. Me, but your marriage wasn't. Here we go with the auntie. Grandma, pass the hot sauce to my dad, please. Pass the hot sauce. Grandma, you get, oh, that's Uncle Robert. I know who I passed it to. Ooh, grandma, let me find out you out here in these streets. That's gonna be it for this Thanksgiving mukbang. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys got a couple laughs out. But honestly, I do wanna say, you know, I don't want to be a basic, corny-ass bitch, but I do want to say I am very thankful for you guys as my family, as my viewers, my subscribers. I hope you guys have a lovely Thanksgiving with your family and your hoe-ass aunts. Please be safe, honestly, like, please be safe. We can all take those walks with our cousins, but, like, y'all gotta be back when the street lights turn on. I hope I don't gain no more weight because I'm tired, bitch. I'm tired of the fucking gym. I do love and appreciate you guys. I hope you guys enjoy your Thanksgiving. Happy food day! And I will see you guys in my next video. Love you guys. Oh, see the guy. Oh, yeah. See the
shady girl, shady girl.